Subora against Vera is brought to you by Monster Energy.
Look for Vera to keep the distance, land some leg kicks. After talking to him a little bit, he's going to stay on the outside, throw some leg kicks to the takedowns there. He'll take it. There he goes. Look for Subora to step in big with some big punches, try and get the knockout. Oh, rocked him already.
Top of the head, and it sent Subora back to the cage
big,
wall.
Big knees, knees to the clinch.
Three knees to the head. The crowd going absolutely crazy here in Manila. Is this going to be a quick finish?
Brandon's doing work right now. He needs to get back on that head kick again. Maybe set it up with a low and then go back up top.
Subora is hurt. He's grimacing despite that flying punch that he just tried.
Boom.
Takes a big kick to the midriff.
But
he's still punching
kick.
Back. Vera still throwing those kicks there to the inside of the thigh.
Brandon's just picking him apart right now. Subora needs to actually back away.
Subora grimaces again. He's suffering pain somewhere. Nice short right hand from the Ukrainian. Solid ramrod jab from Vera.
Brandon's got to keep those hands up, though. Igor's still dangerous. It's first round, it's still fresh. Brandon's pawn on the outside a little bit. But then we probably go to the body, the inside of the leg again. You can tell he's getting ready to throw that kick. Brandon needs to keep those hands up tight, though. Igor's recovered now. He's feeling fresh.
Both men swinging. Both men just ducking under the punches. Heavyweights, it could finish any second. Big man can get that leg up really high. Oh, right hand and a left as well. From Subora.
Subora's bleeding a little bit from the tip, the bridge of his nose.
Eagle's a little bit uncomfortable with something. He's been practicing for a while now, and it could be the nose that's causing him trouble.
Got a little bit of redness around the left eye as well. Brandon keeps switching stance, keeping Igor thrown off a little bit. Boris still dangerous, he's coming in with that big right. This is what he said he was gonna do.
Oh, kick to the midriff. And that kick just above the knee that could hyperextend it. Damaging kick, that is. Straight pushes the thigh back, locks the knee up. Good left hand from Igor. Sent Brandon back a pace. Looks for it again. Leaps in with it. Nice high guard from Brandon Vera. Left hand again from the Ukrainian. Oh, right hand, it was a good one.
Brandon stepping in, throwing those short little choppy elbows. Stand on the outside, really executing his game plan to a T right now. I talked to him the other day, he said this was exactly what he wanted to do.
Brandon looking for the left hand downstairs. Gets clipped by a couple. Oh! The fans here are going nuts. In the end, it finished in super quick style. Devastating punch, and in came the ground kicks. Igor Subora is up on his feet, and he looks okay. Brandon Vera goes over to reach for him on the shoulder, shake his hand.
And what he did is he waited for Igor to throw.
Oh, what a straight left hand that was. And that was more than enough for Olivier Cost. Well, we're bound to be in Manila a couple of times or so, at least in 2015. What's the betting? Brandon Vera will be on most cards. And hopefully elsewhere in Asia. He likes a little dance.
Ladies and gentlemen, referee Olivier Cost calls a hold to this battle at 3 minutes, 54 seconds of round number one. For your winner, via knockout, Brandon, the truth, Vera!
for.
And lands to the head.
Paul Cheng trying to answer. Paul Cheng's got to make this fight dirty. He cannot stand there in front of Brandon Vera and let him do what he does best.
But that left hook did significant damage. That kick landed flush on the jaw. The follow-up barely needed. We have a heavyweight champion.
And now the one heavyweight world champion, Brandon the Truth Vera!
You can see that big height advantage that Vera has immediately.
Yeah, that long reach is going to be a very difficult obstacle for Hideki Sakine to try to get close to. But he is a judo black belt. He's a Brazilian jiu-jitsu black belt. He's got a wealth of grappling experience, so he's got to try to get in there and get one of those legs and drag this fight to the ground.
So far, it's Sakine. Just takes a battering leg to the head, but he continues to circle the perimeter of the cage as Vera stalks him.
Those legs come with such heat and power.
Now he goes downstairs, the outside of Sakine's right leg.
Brandon Vera just stalking forward, looking for these shots. Sakine was almost there, he got close. I don't think Sakine has thrown a strike yet, but he's absorbed a couple of leg kicks. He can't take too many of those, or it's gonna also limit his ability to shoot in and possibly grab that single leg.
Scheduled for 5 5-minute rounds, nobody here at cage side seriously thinks it's gonna go 25 minutes.
He told me he wants to punch his way into a clinch and utilize some of those judo takedowns to get this fight to the ground.
Right hand, knee to the head from Vera. Sakine grabs hold and tries to press Vera up against the cage.
That's what he needs to do. He needs to pressure Vera, stay close to him, eliminate that striking ability, and utilize the takedown.
Tries nice for the clinch. Knee to the head again. Sakine's overhand right missed, and I think he's in a little bit of trouble. Dabs at his right eye. Goes for the single leg, misses it badly. Brandon Vera has an opportunity now, but he backs off. Not wanting to get down there. Right hand straight to Sakine's face, and I think his nose is in a bit of trouble, the Japanese fighter. And the crowd chanting Brandon Vera's name so loudly that I can barely hear myself speak.
Brandon Vera must know that he has a huge advantage on the feet, and he's just waiting to pick his strikes. He's not being too overly aggressive. He knows Sakine is dangerous, and he could clinch up tight and drag the fight to the ground. But Vera's very patient, waiting to pick his shots.
Yeah, he really is being very patient, Vera. He's not going to get too excited and jump into a nest of vipers.
Yeah, his nose definitely looks crooked. I think that shot
definitely didn't look like that when he got in the cage. And that's a huge kick to the head. And that nose will be no better off as a result, I can assure you.
Yeah, his nose is going the wrong way. Oh, a body shot, that hurt him.
And he goes upstairs as well. And it's gonna be a matter of time now. The knee to the head was just an obliterating move. Sakine grabbed for all his worth. Brandon Vera jumps on top, sends in repeated left hands.
One heavyweight world champion, Brandon the Truth Vera!
The time for talk is over. Michael Ciavello, Mitch Chilson with you. It's Mauro Cerilli of Italy. Brandon Vera, defending champion of the Philippines. Vera at 113 kilos. Cerilli at 111 kilos. More beef than a cattle ranch in the cage at the moment. High kick early from Vera. There will be Vera's speed and precision against the raw power of the Italian hammer. And look out for the overhand right on Mauro Cerilli. Cerilli wants to bridge the gap, get on the inside, and go for the champion's jaw.
Cerilli's trying to close that distance, having a hard time dealing with the range of Vera. But he's got to get on the inside. He can't stay at the end of these kicks.
Vera has the height, he's got the reach, wants to keep the Italian at bay, switches to southpaw here. Look out for the high kick off the left leg here from Vera. It's a lead hook, oh, swinging. Oh, he gets caught! That's good!
Moving backwards, looking for the dot. Bingo, right on the button with that fade away left hook. Look at this, going back. Chin up to protect, right on the chin.
Still one heavyweight world champion, Brendan Vera.
Okay. Look out for the hands of Mauro Cerilli, a hammer. Will it be hammer time in Tokyo? Or will Bhullar put him on his back and pound away?
Cerilli's going to have to be careful. He's going to be nice and patient. Not making mistakes, overcommitting on any of his punches.
Outside leg kick from Cerilli. Arjan Bhullar wanted to get in Cerilli's face early on. Cerilli put up a great performance in defeating Alan Galani last time out. Trolling center circle here, the hammer from Italy. Overhand right there from Cerilli, that's it. Bread and butter. Overhand right again from the Italian.
Puts everything he has into that right hand. You can see how he kind of leans forward when he throws it. That little bit of a tell might be what Arjan Bhullar needs to duck underneath and put him on his back.
Outside leg kick to the tip there from Mauro Cerilli. Bhullar thought about the right hand counter, pulled it back though. Cerilli looking through his brow, gloves up high. We talked about the hand power of Cerilli, but Bhullar's got a lot of power of his own, don't worry about that.
Cerilli's being nice and patient here. He's not getting too excited, he's not rushing forward like he did with Brandon Vera, but he is consistently pressing forward, trying to cut the circle off and put Arjan Bhullar's back up against that cage.
If Bhullar puts Cerilli's back on the floor, Cerilli will have a 2010 Commonwealth Games gold medalist on top of him and a 2012 Olympian. Jab two there from Cerilli. Looks for a low single there, does Arjan Bhullar. Tremendous Indian support behind him. It's tackled. There's a nice right hand again from Cerilli.
This is what Bhullar wants. Bhullar wants nice and tight inside the clinch and stay away from those big hammer hands of Cerilli. Circle away from the circle wall.
Last time Bhullar finished an opponent was in October 2016. He took out Chris Katala in Calgary.
Like that overhand right, Bhullar's throwing. He's parrying the punches and then coming over top of that right hand. Nice jab, too.
Cerilli does have 7 first round finishes. The fastest being a 15 second knockout of Carl Moore in March last year in London. And martial arts as a 6-year-old in judo. So no slouch on the ground himself, Cerilli. He does have 3 submissions, which is more than Bhullar, who's only got 1 sub. Point high clean from Mauro Cerilli. Jab right hand from Cerilli. Backs Bhullar against the fence. Gut munching knee there from Arjan Bhullar. Clinches up with the Italian. They tango.
Job from Arjan Bhullar, pressed Cerilli up against the circle wall, but Cerilli's doing a good job of circling out. He's circling to the non-dominant side of Bhullar, landing nice little leg kicks. That leg kick's gonna be important in this match.
Bhullar on debut tonight for one championship, maybe pro debut though, back in November 2014, a third round TKO of Adam Santos. Counts former WWE champion Jinder Mahal amongst his close friends. Overhand right from Cerilli to a left hook. Uppercut from Arjan Bhullar. Sleek seat backed against the fence, turns Cerilli around nicely.
I gotta say, I'm pretty impressed right now so far with Cerilli's takedown defense. The only two real takedown attempts from Arjan Bhullar have been those two attempts at a single leg. And Cerilli's going to step back, counter that, and keep everything up on his feet. But Bhullar's doing a good job utilizing that jab and also landing right hands of his own.
Cerilli hoping to get back-to-back wins in one championship. Had a great streak back in 2012, went 7-0, undefeated for 3 years. Short left hand to the inside, outside leg kick there from Cerilli. Overhand right to the inside. Now he's going to get a gut punching knee from Cerilli.
Cerilli's mixing things up, he's just not throwing the hands. He's also adding knees and that leg kick. It's going to slow Bhullar down and also take away the explosion of that shot, so he's not going to be able to penetrate nice and deep on his shot.
You're right, Mitch, the move that Cerilli tenderizes, that common perennial nerve above the lead knee, the more it's going to affect the shooting in of Arjan Bhullar, the wrestler. Wicked left hand there from Cerilli. Into the first round, we go to the towers after one. Wherever you're watching in more than 140 countries, we hope you're enjoying One Century Live from the Ryokokokokikan in Tokyo. Download the One Super app now, play the One Fantasy game, the largest martial arts game in the world. And you can actually pick who you think will win tonight's contest. If you look at the results of fans on the One Fantasy game, 51% are saying Mauro Cerilli for the win tonight. 46% are tipping Arjan Bhullar.
Well, if the match was stopped right now, fans might be right. I think Cerilli's controlling the distance. He's really found his range. He's not overcoming on the punches, and he's not allowing Bhullar to take him down, which is huge. He's got two successful defenses of that takedown. Let's see how his things progress. I'd like to see him keep going back to that leg kick, but Bhullar's just got to be a little bit more active. He's got to throw a little bit more volume.
Don't forget to follow us across your social media platforms, on Facebook, on Twitter, on Instagram, at One Championship. Let us know where you're watching from around the world. Mauro Cerilli begins with a roundhouse kick, followed by our lead hand. That low single leg is Arjan Bhullar.
Like how he went for the leg tap and also came right back up with that right hand. You can see Cerilli backed up that leg, and then as soon as he did that, Arjan Bhullar came straight down the pipe with a right hand. Nice jab by Bhullar.
Side poke there on the counter from Mauro Cerilli. Accidental, of course. Arjan Bhullar signaling to the referee Olivier Costa. Now, medical crew will take a look at the Indian tie. As you said, Mitch, impressive opening round from Mauro Cerilli. We have a look here at the accidental eye poke. There it is.
Yeah, you can see Cerilli just kind of pawed his hand out there. He's just trying to parry the punch, keep a little bit of space and distance. And you can just see, just sort of popped him in the eye right there. But looks like Arjan Bhullar seems like he's okay. Olivier Cost gives Cerilli a minor warning.
The big meat jacks from Italy. And he unload those hands in the right place and tag Arjan Bhullar on the button. That took there from Arjan Bhullar. Overhand right. High on the balls of his feet. Cannot allow himself to be pressed backwards by Cerilli. Body shot, taking away to the liver, off the left hand there, Bhullar. Left hook from Cerilli, point A, short right hand on the inside, trying to shave the beard of Bhullar. Shoots in for a single, going to hold the leg now, will Cerilli go down? Oh, maintains his vertical base, the Italian.
Beautiful balance from Cerilli. As Bhullar was able to get nice and tight into that single leg. That seems to be his favorite takedown. He's going to the forearm again for the third time. But Cerilli's defended it three times. His confidence has got to be building here.
Now Rose Cerilli cuts off the circle. He's had more combinations than a Chinese gentleman has Mauro Cerilli. Bhullar's got to find a way to get him on his back. Then you'll see Bhullar go to town with his exquisite wrestling skills. And the stand up, it looks like Cerilli has the upper hand.
He's just beaten to the punch just a little bit. He's just got a little bit faster hands, a little bit better timing. He's also established his range. We're we're also seeing, as we're showing that intensity, we're seeing that aggression from Cerilli. He's pushing forward. You can see how he's consistently always in the center of that circle, pushes Arjan Bhullar back.
Bhullar's got the right hand cocked and ready here. Doesn't throw it. Goes for the overhand lift instead. So ask the question, which man is going to slow down first? These are two big fellas in the circle, both weighing over 110 kilograms. Whose gas tank will prevail? Stiff right hand there from Bhullar.
Just barely missed with that, but I like that counter. Cerilli threw two punches. Bhullar leaned back, came back with the right hand. Just barely missed those. Good defense from Cerilli.
Outside leg kick Cerilli.
Not a lot's coming through with the hands, though, for Cerilli. Especially now, Bhullar seems to have really good defense parrying the punches. That's why I like the leg kick of Cerilli. He needs to keep going back to it.
Right hand from Bhullar. And again from Arjan Bhullar. A little bit of pepper behind those punches now.
That two-punch combination got through. You see more volume coming from Bhullar. Nice jab again.
Beautifully threaded through the guard of Cerilli.
Bhullar's got fast hands. Back like that. I wouldn't mind actually to see Cerilli fake that leg kick and go up top even to the body of Bhullar.
Nice knee to the belly button there for Arjan Bhullar. Breaks off back to center circle. 1 minute 20 remains. Second round of three. Most people didn't think it'd go this far. That would be a shock if we go the whole distance.
I'm kind of surprised it's been a kickboxing match at this point.
Don't think we've gone to ground yet, have we, Dragon?
Not yet. And I think a lot of that has to do with Cerilli. He's able to defend the takedowns. He looks good inside the clinch. He's always moving. But Bhullar's got good hands. He's sneaking through. He's scoring a lot of punches. You can see the scorecard is Cerilli's face. He's scoring a lot of damage.
1 in 3 of Arjan Bhullar's wins have come by a knockout. Commonwealth Games gold medalist Arjan Bhullar comes forward. Tremendous crowd support behind him, both in Canada and in India. He's been the center of much media attention in Japan all week. Highly entertaining interview subject, Arjan Bhullar. Hoping to pull the head down of Cerilli, who is. Some blood coming down his right cheek here. Good jab from Bhullar. Quick to the jab is the Indian.
He's scoring well. He's landing that jab. He's got a good punch combination, and he's scoring over and over and over again.
Good knees there. The corner of Cerilli saying throw the knees off the left. In a little Italian I can understand. In the round we got the tap.
You can see as Cerilli's exchanging, Bhullar is deflecting a lot of these punches. He's not really landing clean. But you can see that was a beautiful little uppercut, dirty boxing uppercut landed from Bhullar. He just grabs the back of the head, slides in that uppercut. That is classic AKA right there. They love to control that head, throw with that uppercut shot. You can see that's the scorecard that I'm paying attention to. Look at Cerilli's face. Bhullar is touching him. That's superficial damage, ladies and gentlemen. And Arjan Bhullar looking pretty as ever. A lot of movement, a lot of good head movement coming from Bhullar. Cerilli's got to be a little bit more active this time. He's got to increase the volume and keep landing that leg kick.
Can you believe it? Two titans, two massive heavyweights are in the third and final round. Somewhere they both said they would not be, but here they find themselves. 5 minutes remaining as the circle door is bolted shut.
Ready?
Damage under the right eye of Mauro Cerilli. Sold out inside the Ryokokukikan in Tokyo. 1 century.
A nice jab landed by Arjan Bhullar. Good movement as he's pushing forward. He's got good defense too. His head's never in the same spot. Constantly slipping and moving. I'm impressed with the boxing of Arjan Bhullar. In the first round, I thought it was Cerilli that was going to take advantage of the kickboxing exchanges, but nah, Bhullar's doing good movement. That leg kick's the one thing's really scoring for Cerilli.
Bhullar not afraid to move into the power side of Arjan Bhullar. Down comes the hammer. Is the hammer looking for a takedown?
He's looking for it, but he might not find it.
Hello to all of our fans in India watching on Star Sports and Hotstar. I hope you're enjoying One Century. Nice knee there on the inside from Cerilli. And the behemoth breaks off. Resets. Under 4 minutes remaining. Uppercut. Quick to put the chin through the top of the head. Body shot from Cerilli. Drives the knuckles into the carcass. There's a right hand from Cerilli. Uppercut again from Arjan Bhullar. Shaved him with that one. Now these two men have got to dig deep. Deep into the well of guts and intestinal fortitude and really test the gas tank.
Look at that uppercut. Grabs the back of the head, lands that uppercut. But it's his head movement and his parrying of the hands. Bhullar's got good defense.
3 minutes 20 now. And what has been a torrid final round. Spinning back three from Mauro Cerilli. Arjan Bhullar takes a big lungs full of breath. Both men are spent here. But is there one big shelver, one big tough thumper that can turn the tide for one of these two stars? Commonwealth Games gold medalist, right of screen Arjan Bhullar. Eight Warriors World Heavyweight Champion Mauro Cerilli, left of screen from Italy. Jab again from Bhullar. Like two Mack trucks colliding on a freeway. Cerilli's corner are barking at him to go, go, go now. They know the clock is ticking down. Good leg check there from Bhullar. Outside leg kick from Bhullar. Need to fire a right hand for company. High single leg here from Arjan. And again, Cerilli prevents the takedown.
Cerilli's doing a good job with his takedown defense. He told me that he spent a lot of time preparing for Brandon Vera because he knew Brandon Vera's BJJ skills. So he worked a lot of time on his defense. And he's just been building on that. But you can see that he's got good takedown defense. But I'm surprised by Bhullar's boxing. This is where he's really able to control a lot of these exchanges. He might not be scoring heavily. He might be landing big shots, but he's scored repeatedly. And he's got good defense. Not a lot of these shots have gotten through.
Mauro Cerilli's face is a mess. Much of the goods here, the jabs of Arjan Bhullar. Bhullar the mental. How much has Cerilli got in the tank now? Fires an overhand left, doesn't connect with the Italian. Shrugs off Bhullar. Trying to create space, maybe a right roundhouse kick could be in play for Cerilli. Has he even got the energy to lift that leg? Goes looping instead with the punches. Body shot from Cerilli. Overhook of the left arm by Arjan Bhullar.
See, Cerilli's the one now initiating the clinch game, which I'm a little bit surprised with. I like to see him separate. He's got to do a little bit more, because right now, superficial damage is all over Cerilli's face right now. It's telling us that Bhullar's in control.
Cerilli clinching up with the big Indian. Body shot. Got much indeed. Left hand there from Cerilli. 35 seconds remains. A behemoth's over. Just rising from the forehead of Mauro Cerilli. This has been an incredible contest. It's been a contest of attrition. Cerilli. Double forearm guard there. Left hook uppercut from Arjan Bhullar. Is there one big shot left? One big pump. It's Arjan Bhullar with the left hand. Cerilli with an uppercut and almost takes out the ring lights. And we are going down the judges, which is something nobody expected.
That's true, Michael Spello, but I gotta say, I'm impressed with the Olympic-level wrestler, not so much for his takedowns, but for his boxing. And it was all about that uppercut. I have definite appreciation for what he's doing here. Look at this. And this was the biggest difference, was the angles that Bhullar was coming with. He never just kept throwing the straight punches. He was consistently going from all different angles to score heavily, and that uppercut was the one that we just saw over and over again, scoring, touching up Cerilli. Good effort, 1 billion strong is correct. Arjan Bhullar makes possibly a successful debut here in the One Championship Circle.
Friend, you're watching folks in over 140 countries around the world. How do you score it? Do you have Mauro Cerilli or do you have Arjan Bhullar? Will it be an Italian victory or will it be an Indian victory? Let's go to Tom Lau and find out.
Ladies and gentlemen, after three rounds of battle, we turn now to the judges' scorecards. All three judges have scored this contest in favor of your winner by unanimous decision from the blue corner, Arjan.